Homes are in Pleasanton off Foothill Road near the Arroyo de la Laguna Creek. KPIX 5's Juliette Goodrich is in Pleasanton tonight to show us the growing damage. Jules?
Hi, Veronica. You know, from this vantage point, everything looks fine, like a backyard anyone might have. But if we walk over here, it's entirely different. This backyard has been eaten away, eroded away by Arroyo Creek. This used to extend out about 10 feet. Over to the right, you can see that the fence is starting to go down, and this trampoline here is ready to go anytime. You know, one person told me this looks like a mini Grand Canyon, and that's the best way to describe it. And here are some of the residents.
When the chunks across the way would fall off, you could literally hear them like a loud splash of just massive chunks of dirt falling in.
For Ted Smith and other neighbors living along Arroyo Creek, it's a race against time, or rather, Mother Nature.
You could literally hear, like, I'll bet it was 100 cubic yards at a time falling off into the Arroyo.
What was going through your mind? That's my backyard.
Oh my God! Literally, we were crapping our pants.
Every day, neighbors hope something can be done to stabilize the bank. This video was taken 10 days ago, and you can see just how much this backyard has eroded. To give you another view, we're on the other side of Arroyo Creek, and now you can see their backyard and get a real sense of just how sheer that cliff is and just how much it's eating away into their backyard.
They've got a swimming pool that I know, you know, the weight of the pool and the water, it's just going to force that to go if they don't do something very quickly.
But until Zone 7 Water Agency finishes its surveys they've been doing and the Army Corps of Engineers signs off on an emergency permit, everyone's hands are tied, rain or no rain. And this gives you another view of the other side of the creek, so you can see just how it's starting to erode away. You can see the roots from the tree, and you can see how the water is just kind of meandering and making its own route down the way here. You know, neighbors are living on edge, literally, and they're on edge politically, just waiting for hopefully to get some things signed and sealed so they can get some work done. But everyone's being patient, and they know that hopefully things will get done soon. Veronica.
Understandably so. Juliet, we have a few dry days ahead. Is that giving neighbors hope?
Yeah, that's the good news. Certainly the dry days are helpful. However, even on a dry day, you know, part of the chunks of the cliff here are still going, and it's kind of a tease because they'd love to get down there and be able to stabilize this cliff, but they can't do it until those permits are signed. So they hope that'll happen anytime soon, and we'll report back when it does.
Sounds good, Juliet. We appreciate it. Thank you.